वंदे गुजरात।
डियर CSIR, ICAR, JNU CEB एस्पिरेंट्स, आई डॉक्टर कुंदन मिश्रा, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट NV पटेल कॉलेज ऑफ प्योर एंड अप्लाइड साइंसेज वल्लभ विद्यानगर आनंद, इज गोइंग टू डिस्कस अप्लाइड बायोलॉजी ट्रांसजेनिक एनिमल्स एंड प्लांट्स मॉलिक्यूलर अप्रोचेज टू देयर डायग्नोसिस डिपिक्टेड इन नेट सिलेबस। इफ यू विल सी द अप्लाइड बायोलॉजी, देर आर डिफरेंट सब हेडिंग्स लाइक फर्मेंटेशन टेक्नोलॉजी, ट्रांसजेनिक प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स, देन एनिमल सेल कल्चर, एनिमल टिश्यू कल्चर्स, बायोसेंसर्स, जीनोमिक्स एंड देयर एप्लीकेशन इन एग्रीकल्चर, फाइटो रिमेडिएशन, बायो रिमेडिएशन एक्सेट्रा। बट आई विल फोकस मोर ऑन ट्रांसजेनिक प्लांट्स एंड देयर एनिमल्स एंड मॉलिक्यूलर डायग्नोसिस। आई हैव डिवाइडेड माय प्रेजेंटेशन इन टू पार्ट्स। वन विल बी कवर ट्रांसजेनिक प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स, मेथड्स टू क्रिएट ट्रांसजेनिक प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स, देयर एप्लीकेशन इन द फील्ड ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर्स, इन द फील्ड ऑफ medical science, etc. And then model questions and some of the questions which has been already asked in CSIR NET examination and JNU CEB. And presentation 2, I will discuss molecular diagnosis of transgenic plants and animals and questions based on CSIR, ICAR NET, GATE and JNU CEB. So, if we will see transgenic animals, I will discuss what is transgenic animals, how transgenic animals can be created in laboratory, common method, and how transgenic animals will be useful for human welfare. And then we will see important questions, model question based on topic. So far this transgenic animals is concerned, we can define transgenic animals by insertion of foreign functional DNA from any source to modify the genome for a specific purpose. And the purpose includes only two things. One is to protection of animals against diseases, and another one is quality enhancement. Quality enhancement in terms of protein contents, quality enhancement in terms of the some of the immunological components like expression of interferons, interleukins, cytokines, and then increasing the growth size. And then these animals can be also used as a model organisms for study of variety of disorders, genetic disorders, non-genetic disorders, etc. So it was Paul Meter et al. In 1982 who first constructed transgenic mice by insertion of human growth hormones with fusion with human metallothionein promoters. And thereafter, lot of transgenic animals have been created in laboratory, like transgenic sheep, transgenic rabbit, transgenic goat, transgenic cat, transgenic cow, buffalo, etc. So, creation of transgenic animals depends on selection of species. First, we will have to select the species by which we want to transfer a specific genes for particular purpose. So, animals has to be selected first, and then the gene which we want to insert or transfer in that particular species. So first cell has to be also selected, cells has to be also cultured, and then a specific gene transfer strategy has to be decided. Which particular techniques will be suitable for which particular species, that has to be decided first. Then gene has to be transferred by that process. And then selection has to be made through either reporter genes or some of the selectable markers. And then animals can be created, and then after breeding, a homozygous line can be established, and that can be used for further breeding, further generation, further production of transgenic animals for variety of purpose. So there are few common methods that can be used for creation of transgenic animals. One is microinjection of genes into pronuclei of fertilized ova, microinjection of embryonic stem cell, DNA transferred by retrovirus, liposomes mediated DNA transferred into the cell, electroporation of DNA into a sperm, ova, or embryos, especially in the case of transgenic fish, and biallelistic or gene gun method. there are 6-7 methods depicted here, but if you will see creation of transgenic animals in vertebrate, particularly mice, then rabbit or monkey or whatever I said, three methods are commonly used. First one is engineered stem cell method. Engineered stem cell method is one of the most suitable method to create transgenics, and chimera can be created. After fertilizations, after 1 to 2 weeks, there will be formation of blastocyst. And that blastocyst is basically 32-celled stage embryo, where the whatever cells are present, that has ability to transform into any cell, what we call embryonic stem cell. That embryonic stem cells has to be isolated from blastocyst, cultured it, nourished it, and then the construct can be used for transfection, that may be retrovirus or microinjection, and then transformed cell or transfected cells can be selected and re-implant into the surrogate host, and after gestation period, a screening of transgenic can be possible. A screening of transgenic can be made, and that can be used further for breeding. Another important method one is microinjection of embryonic stem cells directly. We will have to take the zygote. After fertilization, zygote can be collected, and male and female pronuclei will be visible under inverted microscope, which is one of the part of microinjection apparatus. And then gene can be delivered specifically into male pronuclei, and thereafter the zygote can be re-implanted into the surrogate host, and after complete gestation period, transgenic can be born. And third important one is retrovirus. The retrovirus, which can replicate via RNA intermediates, can be used as one of the most routine method to transfer specific genes into mammalian cell. Why retrovirus is preferable? Because retrovirus usually do not kill the host by lytic cycles, and DNA can be stably integrated into the genome, and it can be easily disarmed. If we will see the structure of retrovirus on teletop, the retrovirus, teletop please, the retrovirus has different type of genes. Almost 9 genes are there. One is LTR at 5 prime sequence, long terminal repeat sequence, which is essential for integration. Then Psi sequences, which is also called PBS, promoter binding sites, and GAG, Paul, envelope, ENT, these genes are there. This LTR, long terminal repeat sequences, is essential for integration. And another genes, if we will remove, then whatever cassettes or foreign gene we want to transfer, that can be integrated. So after taking this retrovirus, LTR sequence can be retained, and cassettes can be combined. LTR along with cassette can be used for transfection. Cells can be selected, that may be embryonic stem cells, that may be zygote, that may be embryo at premature stage. This can be used, and this cassette can be transfected along with helper virus. Helper virus will constitutes only GAG plus Pol plus envelope gene, and it lacks LTR. So what happened? The genes which we want to transfer will multiply inside the cells with helper virus. This gene will be multiplied, and then only those gene will be transferred which has LTR, because LTR is essential for integration in the host cells, and then target cell can be selected on the basis of reporter genes, and transgenic can be created. So this one is, retrovirus is one of the most suitable vector for gene transfer into mammalian cells. Another one is liposome mediated gene transfer. Liposomes is a lipid, phospholipid bilayers, and it can be circulated spontaneously when it transferred into alkaline medium. So if there will be any DNA, RNA or protein, but here I will have to discuss DNA, genes. So if genes will be already present in alkaline buffer, and if we will put phospholipid bilayer, it can be circularized spontaneously, and then the gene can be directly delivered into the animal cell. Animal cell lacks cell wall, so only there will be plasma membrane. And if liposomes containing encapsulated DNA, if this will be put together in presence of polyethylene glycol or Sendai virus we are not using now. Polyethylene glycol or sometime electroporation can be used. Then this DNA can be directly delivered into the cell through endocytosis. So liposomes methods can be also used for gene transferred into selected cells. Then electroporation can be used for some of the somatic cells. It is not advisable to use in germinal cell because germinal cell do not tolerate much electric current and cell can be die. Another important one is bioelastic or gene gun method that I will discuss in gene transfer in plants, where micro projectiles, gold or tungsten particles can be used for precipitation of genes, and it can be delivered through gene gun barrel into the selected cell. So these are the few methods which can be used for creation of transgenics in the laboratory. And after creation of transgenic, why transgenic can be created? So purpose of creation of transgenics is very large. If we will see the purpose and application of transgenic animals, I have divided application of transgenic animals in few sections. Like transgenic animals is one of the important source for food. We are dependent on animals for milk, for meat, for flesh, for proteins, for some biological enzymes like that. So transgenic animals purposely created to enhance the food quality. Say example, if we want to transfer, suppose, growth hormones, genes for growth hormones into the fish, then if we will see the normal multiplication and dividing rate of fish, it is very slow process. But if growth hormones can be inserted from another source, then its development can be accelerated and it will gain the weight in less period. So demand and supply, the demand will be fulfilled, constant demand can be fulfilled. And beside this, antifreeze, there are so many proteins which can be used as a drugs, like tissue plasminogen activator, which can be used for coronary thrombosis. Then alpha antitrypsin, this can be used in emphysema. So if we will insert this gene from different sources, there is no crossing barrier, so any gene can be transferred from any source, either from bacteria or from another animals or sometime plants or whatever. Then what happens? These proteins can be secreted through lactation in lactation-based animals like cow, like buffalo, like goat, like sheep. So transgenic animals can be used for creation of supplying food, balancing the food in growing populations. Then these transgenic animals can be also used as a disease model. Whatever information we have for different diseases like cancer, HIV, some of the immunological disorders like CID, then some of the metabolic disorders, some of the genetic disorders. So whatever information we have, it is because of creation of transgenic. Genes can be transferred into the specific animals, and we can monitor, we can see the effect of that particular genes, presence and absence, how their metabolism are affected, and then drugs can be designed, new drugs can be evolved, new drugs can be designed, their effect can be monitored. So transgenic animals is one of the important disease model. Third one is a study of gene expression. If we will see any animals, any higher animals, then we can say that only 2-3% sequences are considered as genes. Rest of the sequences are junk DNA or non-coding sequences that doesn't have much effects of specific phenotypic traits. So whatever genes essential for a specific purpose, say molecular events like replication, transcription, translation, post-translational modification, signal transduction, cell cycle regulations, then metabolism, electron transport system, Krebs cycle, then synthesis of variety of different pathway, for example, vitamin synthesis, provitamin synthesis. So whatever information we have for a specific genes and their role, the transgenic animals is used as a model. If gene can be identified, gene can be screened, and their effect can be monitored. So idea of gene expression patterns can be possible through transgenic animals. Then another important one is xenotransplantation. There are four type of transplantation we know: isograft, allograft, xenograft. So far, xenograft is concerned, if we are transferring a specific organs from across the different species, then this can be called xenotransplantation. Like if animal organ can be transplanted into the human being, this can be called xenotransplantation. But here is a problem. There will be hyperacute rejection because immune system of human beings and animals are different. But it has been seen ki if genes responsible for immunity regulations from human being can be transferred into the animals, then their organ can be used for transplantation. And for that, pig can be considered as one of the best model for xenotransplantation, means transfer of animal organ to human being, because of several similarity. Pig's organs are very similar to human beings. Their size, their structures are similar. Only difference is immune system. So what scientists are trying, they are trying to transfer MHC genes as well as some of the genes which can control the immunity from human being to pigs. And if this all gene will be expressed together, then pig will be used as a donor for organ. And we know that millions and millions of people died every year in India and globally because of organ failure or because of less organ donor or no organ donor. So if this will be served, then millions and millions life will be saved in future. Trials is going in India and abroad. Another one is scientific models. Scientific models, how specific genes can be transferred from generation to generation, how their effect will be there, how their actions can be monitored and minimized, and what are different corrective measures can be taken to modify, to improve the quality of animals in terms of protections and quality enhancement. That for that purpose, transgenic animals can be used as a scientific model. So these are the brief overview about the application of transgenic animals, particularly in the area of medical science, in the area of food science, in the area of medical science, in the area of transplantation, and in the area of molecular biology, genetics and molecular biology. So now come to the questions which has been already asked in NET CSIR examinations, and I have incorporated some of the model question also based on the concept of transgenic animals. And if we will see the questions, then questions are basically based on concept. So concept is needed for solving any type of questions. First one, the transfections refers to which of the following? Transfections refers to which of the following? Transfection means transfer of DNA or transfer of genes from any source to the target animals. That can be possible through vector method, that can be possible through chemical method, that can be possible through physical method that I had already discussed. So first one is synthesis of mRNA from DNA template. This is called reverse transcription. Synthesis of mRNA from DNA is basically called transcription. So this is not right. Synthesis of protein based on mRNA sequence. This is one of the steps of translation. Not correct. Third one is introduction of foreign DNA into a cell. This one is right. Transfer of DNA, foreign functional DNA from any source to target cell is called transfections. Transformation and transfections are sometimes distinct but confusing. If we will see the word transfection, it means delivering of DNA which can be integrated or incorporated into the eukaryotic genome. But transformation means transfer of DNA which may be replicated independently in the host, like plasmid DNA, or sometime it can be integrated into the host genome. But here, if we will see the word transfection, it means introduction of foreign DNA into the cell that can be integrated into the eukaryotic genome. So C is right one. The process by which a normal cell becomes malignant cell, this is called transformation. This method can be used for conversion of finite cell line into continuous cell line by introduction of carcinogen, mutagen, or sometime virus to convert normal cell into cancer cell. So C option is correct one. Introduction of foreign DNA into the cell is called transfection. This question has been asked in JNU CEB. So another one, simple question. Which of the following method for the production of transgenic mice involve the initial creation of cell chimera, a mixture of cell from distinct sources? First one is pronuclear microinjection. This pronuclear microinjection can be used for gene transfer into the zygote. And in the case of zygote, if we transfer genes, then chimera will not there. Chimera means heterogeneous type of cell, heterogeneous mass of cell. And if one cell can be targeted, then this cannot be called chimera. Retroviral transductions. This can be also used for transfer of genes into the specific cell, as I discussed earlier. And this cannot create chimera. A specific gene can be directly delivered into a specific cell. Third one is transfection of embryonic stem cell. As I said earlier, this embryonic stem cells can be isolated from blastocyst, and this can be enriched or cultured, and then construct or gene can be transferred either through microinjection or retrovirus. So what happens, some of the cell may acquire the gene, some do not. So there will be possibility of creation of chimera. So transfection of embryonic stem cells is right answer. This can be used for creation of chimera, mixtures of cell from distinct sources. Next one, the major differences between the transgenic mice and knockout mice is that knockout mice, first I will have to discuss the difference between knockout and transgenic. Transgenics means the animals which contains foreign functional DNA which must express, means that must perform a specific functions after integration into the genome. But knockout mice are specially created to inactivate the existing genes present in that animals through transfer of mutant copy of genes by a process called homologous recombination. So knockout mice means inactivation of their original genes by transferring mutant copy of genes to see their effect on the cell metabolism, to see the absence of that particular genes and their effect of metabolism. So knockout and transgenics are different, although method is same means the stem cells can be isolated from the source and gene can be delivered. If gene will be integrated, correct copy of functional genes will be integrated into the genome, then that will be called transgenic animals. But in knockout, we will have to decide the strategy. Gene can be integrated at particular location through homologous recombination. So a specific construct or mutant copy of genes along with certain selectable markers has to be designed before creating the knockout mice. Knockout mice will contain inactivated copy or mutant copy of functional genes. So first option, transgenic mice always employed the use of clone genes derived from other species, is not 100% right. Transgenic mice may employ the genes, clone genes from another sources, but not always. Transgenic mice have foreign genes that integrate at targeted loci through homologous recombination. This is character of knockout mice. Transgenic mice have a foreign functional genes added to their genome. This one is a right answer, because transgenic mice or transgenic animals must have foreign functional copy of genes which must be integrated into the genome and which can be expressed. Knockout mice always have unique phenotype. This is not true. Some of the genes may be used for altering the metabolism that cannot be captured or that cannot be analyzed through phenotypic analysis. So this one is not right. C1 is perfect answer. Transgenic mice always have a foreign functional gene added or integrated into their genomes. A mouse in which one particular gene has been replaced by its inactivated from generated in vitro is called, I had already spoken earlier, it's a knockout mice. The existing genes can be inactivated by mutant copy of genes for a specific purpose. Now this question belongs to the method, common method used for gene transfer into the animal cell. Which of the following can be used to transfect DNA into mammalian cell? Liposomes, Liposomes is a phospholipid bilayer which can be circularized spontaneously when transferred into any alkaline medium. This cholesterol has no any correlation with gene transfer. Another one is CACL2 plus HAPS buffer. This is called chemical method of gene transfer, calcium chloride mediated and calcium phosphate mediated gene transfer. Here what happened? DNA has ability to precipitate with calcium ion in alkaline solution, and if we will put a specific genes or DNA sequences in alkaline solution along with calcium phosphate, then this can form precipitate with DNA. And if we will put into the animal cells, then calcium can be entered by calcium requiring process, what we call active transport. Along with that, DNA can be also entered. So this method can be used for gene transfer in certain mammalian cell. Third one is magnesium chloride. It cannot be used as a gene transfer method. So if we will see options, then P, liposomes, it's a chemical method of gene transfer and can be used frequently. And another one is calcium chloride plus HEPS buffer, means calcium phosphate. This can be used for gene transfer or transfections of DNA into the mammalian cell. So answer will be P and R. P and R, C is correct answer. P and R, this is chemical method of gene transfer into the mammalian cell. Third one, it's a very simple question based on application of transgenic animals. Transgenic animals may show increased growth rate. Of course, it can be used for increasing the weight, particularly in the case of transgenic fish, goat. That can be used as a protein supply, main source of protein supply in the form of meat. Disease resistance power. Yes, animals can be protected against variety of diseases, and certain genes for immunity can be transferred. Then increased production of milk. Lactation can be enhanced by overexpression of lactating pathway genes, and that has been already done in Australia and in England, UK, by transferring a cascade copy, multiple series of genes one by one into cow and buffalo. So all three, increased growth rate, disease resistance power, and increased production of milk, these all three can be shown by transgenic animals, and therefore all of the above is correct answer. Next one, again from gene transfer technique. The advantage of using liposomes as a gene carrier includes: does not affect the integrity of cell, right? Liposomes is basically phospholipid bilayer, so it not interfere the any process, any metabolic another process in the cell. So it does not affect integrity of cell. Liposomes are non-immunogenic, very right, because if we will see the nature of immunogenic compounds, it is basically proteins, and majority of antigens are proteinous by nature. Therefore, our cell can show immune response against that. But liposome is phospholipid bilayer, it doesn't have any correlation with immunity. And liposomes protect the DNA from attack by nuclease. This is true. Nuclease are frequently present in cytoplasm, and when DNA comes, then nuclease try to bind, like DNA is one, the exonuclease. These enzymes can be bind to the DNA and try to degrade the DNA molecules. But if it is encapsulated under liposomes, then nuclease cannot bind and DNA protein interaction will not possible, and DNA gets protected. So this one is also right. So we can say all these three, A, B, C is right answers. All of the above is correct answer. Another one is the biologic PDS 1000 is N. Actually, this is components of gene gun method or bioblaster method or particle acceleration method. This biologic PDS 1000 is components of gene gun method, where cartridge or helium gas along with coated metal, particularly gold and copper, gold and platinum, can be used for gene transfer. So multiplication of antibiotic drugs is not right answer. Gene therapy operation technique, no. There are three techniques of gene therapy. One is somatic cell gene therapy, germinal cell gene therapy, and that includes antisense RNA therapy also. So this is not gene therapy operating technique. Then instrument used to transfer DNA to wide range of cells and tissues, gene gun method. And this biolastic or PDS-1000 is a component of that. So C is right answer. Instrument used to transfer DNA to a wide range of cell and tissues. Important cell fusion technique is somatic cell hybridization. For that, polyethylene glycol and Sendai virus and sometime electroporation can be used, but biolastic never. So C is right answer. The transgenic pigs with gene for human antigens will be useful for providing best human food? No. Resistance to common human diseases? No, this one is not right. Having all important blood factors? No. Organ transplantation. As I said earlier, ki pig's organ, heart, liver, kidney, their, you know, size and their, you know, structure, their configuration are very similar to human being, approximately 98 to 99%, and therefore the gene for immunity can be transferred at regular intervals in pigs to show immune response against human antigens, and therefore this can be used for transplantation in future. So transgenic pigs with gene for human antigens will be useful for organ transplantation, although trials is going, success story is not there. The first transgenic animals constructed in laboratory was, it was Palmiter et al. In 1982, who constructed transgenic mice first through microinjection technique by transferring human growth hormones that was fused with mouse metallothionein promoters. So mice having human growth hormone, somatotropin is right answer. Sheep having HGS that was later produced in 1988, goat having TPA 1988, and rabbit having TPA 1989. So these all are transgenics, but first transgenic animals was transgenic mice where human growth hormone genes was successfully transformed along with MT promoter. Which of the following can be used as a target cell for creation of transgenic fish? Transgenic fish, we know that their fertilization is external. There is no internal fertilization. And fishes can lay their eggs in, you know, certain temperatures in water. And that temperature influences the expression of few genes. And that can cause laying of eggs by fish in water. So egg cell alone cannot be used as a gene transfer. A sperm cell alone cannot be used as a gene transfer. Different embryo at different stages can be routinely used as a gene transfer. So embryo and germinal cells, basically these two cells can be targeted for gene transfer through microinjection. But in the case of fish embryo, the female and male pronuclei are not visible, so it's very difficult to transfer genes through microinjection sometime, so electroporation may be used. So D is the right answer. Embryo and germinal cell can be used for gene transfer into the fish to create transgenic fish. Salmon, Atlantic salmon, and common carp, then goldfish, then zebrafish, and this catfish, their gene for pig growth hormones, the gene for antifreeze proteins, the genes for TPA has been already transferred and expressed. This one is asked in NET examination. What is the primary purpose of neomycin in creating mice with knockout in a gene X? Neomycin selects for the survival of embryonic stem cell that have incorporated the mutant gene X anywhere in the genome. This is not true. Neomycin cannot be used for selection of embryonic stem cells where mutant genes can be incorporated into the genome. Neomycin select for survival of embryonic stem cells that have incorporated the mutant gene in place of wild type genes. Yes, for creation of knockout mice, it is mandatory to select the transfected cell, and for that, selectable reporter genes can be used. Mostly, we preferring thymidine kinase or neomycin phosphotransferase, or some of the another, you know, genes that can be fused with a mutant copy of genes to select the cells which has mutant copy of genes. So neomycin prevents candida infection during ES cell culture that does not have a gene X. No, neomycin cannot work against candida infections for embryonic stem cell. Neomycin makes the gene X knockout mice resistant to candida. There is no correlation. So B1 is right. Neomycin select for the survival of embryonic stem cell that have incorporated the mutant genes in the place of wild type genes through homologous recombination, as I discussed earlier. Another important one is transgenic plants. And why transgenic plants? So transgenic plants can be constructed in laboratory for two purposes: plant protections as well as quality enhancement. We know that our country is agriculture based, and we are dependent on agriculture for variety of purposes like food, cloth, medicine, drugs, etc., etc. Population is increasing day by day, and the land for cultivation or culturing land, agriculture land, is reducing day by day. The plant breeding has already exploited much, and there is no much scope for development of varieties through breeding technique. So it is mandatory to avoid the crossing barrier between the species that can be used in the case of plant breeding. There is a crossing barrier, and that has to be avoided to transfer specific genes from any source. For that, what happened? The production can be accelerated as well as whatever desirable proteins or desirable contents we want to impart in desirable crop, that can be possible through creation of transgenics. So if we will see the development in the area of transgenic plants, first transgenic plant was produced in 1981, and thereafter a lot of attempts have been made, and more than 80 transgenic crops has been already generated through transfer of variety of genes for either herbicide resistance, insecticide resistant, pesticide resistance, vitamin contents, protein rich, oil seed, then oil contents, and lycopene contents. That genes has been already transferred in variety of crops, and that if you will see the present scenario of cultivation of transgenic crops across the globe, then around 800 million hectares can be used for cultivation of transgenic crops, and it may be raised up to 2000 million hectares around 2020. Approximately 8 to 10 million farmers are engaged for cultivation of this transgenic crop globally. And of course, transgenic plants can in future can solve the demand as well as requirement of food in different sectors. So transgenic plants can be created by variety of methods. Variety of gene transfer, first I will come to the application of transgenic plants. There are variety of application of transgenic plant. As I said, it can be used for creation of herbicide resistance. Herbicide can affect the growth of our desirable crop in field, and therefore herbicide can be used to suppress the growth of weeds or herbs. But this can also kill our desirable plant, and this will lower the production of grains as well as desirable food products, desirable crop products. So herbicide resistance as insecticide. Insect can destroy the crop and 30 to 40% less yield, and sometime 100% damaged of crop is reported. So it is mandatory to develop the insect resistance plants to increase or to enhance the productivity of crop. Then stress, particularly salinity, if you will see the agriculture land of India or globally, it is decreasing, but coastal regions where the salt concentration are very high, there we cannot propagate our desirable crop. But if we will isolate the genes which can control the salinity pathway and transferred into the desirable crop, then that crop can be grown in that particular area. Beside this, drought resistance drought resistance plants can be also created, and that is already cultivated, particularly rice, cottons. This drought resistance gene has been already transferred. Maize. So what I'm saying that a lot of transgenic plants have been created for specific traits like disease resistance, insect resistance, pest resistance, virus resistance, etc. And then imparting the quality of desirable amino acid contents, desirable protein contents, desirable vitamin contents like golden rice. The golden rice has been developed by Ingo Potricus and Boyer by transferring three genes, one from bacteria and two for daffodils, to express the beta carotene into the rice. We know that rice plants are lack of provitamin A or beta carotene, and because of insertion of these three genes together, we can increase the contents of provitamin A in rice, and therefore it can be used as a staple food, and the problem of night blindness can be overcome in futures. So these are the few applications. One important one is increasing shelf life, enhance shelf life. Flavor saver tomato is one of the best example, where the gene for polygracturinase, responsible for softening the tissue by degrading pectin, the gene for antisense RNA has been inserted in tomato, and their expression can be reduced up to 40%. So that can increase the shelf life of tomato, and this can be used for transportation, and tomato is available globally, where it is cultivated or not cultivated. Another one is nutritional quality. I have said it's all about protein content, vitamin contents, oil contents, sulfur containing amino acid like cysteine, methionine. Then edible vaccines, trials is going, there is no success story so far edible vaccine is concerned, but trials is going, where a specific genes for particular antigens, and the peoples are trying to transfer into the plants, and then they impart a series of antigenic genes as well as immunogenic genes through a breeding experiment. Means, suppose one plant is A, selected another B. So, say example, gene for IgG, there will be heavy chain genes, light chain genes, and J chain genes. So these all cannot be transferred simultaneously. So A plants, their gene for light chains can be inserted, and B plant gene for heavy chain can be inserted. This can be breed. So C can be created, and this C can be crossed with J chain. Then D can be created, and this D can be used for breeding to transfer the genes for a specific antibody as well as antigens. So trials is going. Stress tolerance, as I said, salt resistance, drought resistance, then salinity resistance. Biotic stress, particularly nematodes, bacterial, fungals, diseases, the genes for that has been already inserted, and transgenics have been already created. These are the overview of application of transgenic plants. So far, method to create transgenic plants is concerned. There is animals, this is not true, method to create transgenic plants. There are variety of methods used can be creation of transgenic plants. Biological, physical and chemical method. Biological method includes TI plasmid based vector. TI plasmid is a plasmid which is present in Agrobacterium tumefaciens, and it has TI plasmid, if we will see a TI plasmid, there is a tDNA transfer DNA, which has genes for synthesis of auxins, cytokinin, like that. Then it has nopalin as well as octopine. So on the basis of opine, different type of TI plasmid are there. Then vir genes are there that can be essential for virulence, and then tra genes, conjugative type of plasmid, it is there. So what happened? This tDNA can be integrated into the plant genome through Agrobacterium tumefaciens because of VIR. Monocot and dicot. Dicot plants can secrete a phenolic compound called acetoserinone alpha hydroxyacetoserinone, which are inducer of VIR region, and because of that, genes located in between tDNA, there is left and right border sequences present, their tDNA can be excised and it can be integrated into the plant genome when lesion is made in any plant cells, and this can start abnormal synthesis of auxin and cytokinin and leads to formation of a tumor, what we call Crown-Gall's diseases. If we will isolate this TI plasmid and disarm it, it's a big plasmid, approximately 200 to 250 kb, depending on type of nopalin, octopine nopalin type. So if the genes responsible for tumor injection can be eliminated, then a specific cassette or particular genes can be inserted into the in between right and left border of tDNA, and it can be used for routine gene transfer in many dicot plants through either leaf disc technique or through protoplast techniques or through protoplast can be used for gene transfer through tDNA. So this tDNA has ability to integrate into the plant genome directly in presence of VIR region, and therefore a strategy have been made to design some of the vector like co-integrate and binary vector, and this can be routinely used for gene transfer into the monocot plant. Dicot are little bit resistant because they do not have inducer of VIR genes, like as I said, acetoserinone and alpha hydroxyacetoserinone, which are one of the inducer of VIR gene, that is not present in monocot. But if we introduce these compounds, acetoserinone or alpha hydroxyacetoserinone, in monocots, then TI plasmid can be also used for gene transfer, and it has been successfully used in the case of tobacco plant in 1981, and thereafter it can be routinely used for gene transfer in many plants like cotton, like maize, like canola, like sugarcane, and even rice also. So these, you know, vector method, particularly TI plasmid based vectors, are routinely used for gene transfer in plant cells. Beside this, physical method, electroporation, particle bombardment, microinjection, liposome mediated, which I had already discussed. But in electroporations, here what happened? The protoplast or the plant cells where we want to introduce a specific genes, first protoplast can be created, and then the DNA or gene which we want to transport, these can be put together in a cuvette, electroporation cuvette, and then there will be gene pulser. Gene pulser is a part of electroporation instrument. Gene pulser, where will we decide how much electric current has to be supplied for effective transfer of genes. How gene transferred into the protoplast or target cell, that not fully understood, but it has been seen if electric current can be given, this can create temporary pores into the plasma membrane. And that can sometime causes effective transfer of DNA inside the cell, and it can be integrated into the cell, and that can be further screened or further identified, and then transgenic plants can be created. In chemicals method, PEG mediated polyethylene glycol can be used for fusion of DNA molecules into the target cell, and then calcium phosphate co-precipitation, as I discussed earlier, this can be used. But most common method is TI plasmid based vector as well as TI electroporation, this can, or particle bombardment, this can be used for routine transfer of genes into the target plant cell. Now I will have to discuss important question based on this particular topic. Agrobacterium tumefaciens is often used as a vehicle to introduce foreign DNA into the plant. The agrobacterial tDNA in plant cells can be found as and autonomously replicating nuclear plasmid? This is not true. A mitochondrial plasmid? No. Mitochondria never be a plasmid. A chloroplast plasmid? Never. Yes, this tDNA can be integrated into the plant genomes. So tDNA in plants can be found as directly integrated into the plant genome and considered as plant of genome temporarily. Resistance to herbicide glyphosate in transgenic plants is brought by glyphosate is a herbicide which can be used for if this gene will be overexpressed EPSP synthase, then glyphosate tolerant will be present in transgenic plants and plant can be survive and weed can be killed. So overproduction of RNA polymerase, no, this is used for transcription. There is no correlation of glyphosate to RNA polymerase. Underproduction of EPSP, if underproduction of EPSP synthase will be there, then plant will be die. Overproduction of EPSP synthase, if overproduction will be there, then the transgenic plant can be survive in presence of glyphosate, even in heavy concentration. Overproduction of aspartate amino acid transferase, it doesn't have any correlation with glyphosate degradation. Which of the following statement is most appropriate for recombinant antibody production in transgenic plant? This is more or less related to edible vaccines. A very high level expression is always obtained. It's not right. Light chain promote more antibody production. No, light, heavy, J. All three are essential. Such antibodies are free from other antigen of the animal origin. Of course, if another antigens will be there, then this will not work and it will lead to abnormalities as well as rejections. Functional antibody cannot be produced in plant. It can be produced, as I said earlier. So C is right answer. Next one. The essential components of TI plasmid required for integration into the plant genome is origin of replications. Of course, TRA gene is required. Tumor inducing genes. The essential component of TI plasmid required for integration into the plant genome. Whole tumor inducing genes is not required, but right and left border sequence is required. Nopalin utilization gene. Yes, nopalin is essential for providing energy to the Agrobacterium tumefaciens. So all of the above is correct. A stable transformation of plants is reliable obtained by Agrobacterium plasmid integration. Yes, this will be responsible for a stable integration. Electroporation, microinjection and silicon carbide whisker is a physical method that doesn't give a stable integration of DNA. Production of transgenic cotton resistance to Lepidopteran insect utilize a toxin producing gene isolated from Bacillus thuringiensis. It's a most simple question. This one is little bit difficult. This question has been asked in NET examination. Group 1 is a technique of gene transfer method to the plant cell and group 2 indicates the techniques or the components of particular instrument. Like biolistic always required PDS 1000 as a tools. Then Agrobacterium, there is a need of vir genes, vir operons. Then electroporation, there is a need of gene pulsar. And then microinjection, there is need of micromanipulator. So if we will match it, then this P2, Q5, R1 and S3 is right. Which of the following is not a vehicle for insertion of foreign DNA into plant cell for plant cell chromosome? tDNA is right. PBR322, it's a bacterial plasmid. It can replicate independently in the bacterial cell. It cannot integrate into the plant genome. So PBR is not right. AC elements of maize, it's a transposon and it can be used as a vector for gene transfer. rDNA of Agrobacterium rhizogenes, this can be also used for gene transfer in plant cell. So PBR322 is not right answer. What role do opines play in crown gall diseases? It's a source of carbon, nitrogen, and energy for the Agrobacterium tumefaciens by catabolic metabolism. So A is right answer. What roles does acetosaringone? As I said earlier, it's an inducer of vir genes. So it can induce expression of cluster of vir genes A2H, and that is essential for a stable integration of foreign DNA into the plant genome. Increase flavor shelf life to the tomato has been achieved by reducing activity of enzyme polygactrinase, as it's responsible for softening the tissue, plant tissue, pectin. Genetically modified food can be harmful because it can cause allergy, toxicity, antibiotic disturbance of metabolism. All of the above is correct. And sustainable agriculture, in agriculture, which gives optimum yields indefinitely, is right. Uses little non-renewable resources, right. Employ renewable resources, right. Means all of the above is correct one. So, I have tried my level best to discuss some of the model question based on NET, CSIR and JNU CEB. I hope you will utilize it, and if you have any queries, let me know. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Vande Gujarat.